Shalom chaverim, and ברוכים הבאים to a special study through Sefer Hageulah, the Book of Redemption, by the Ramban. We have already begun our journey with the Ramban when learned that he stated clearly that our job in the last days is to proclaim the redemption, to bring Israel from a galut, from an exile, to the Geulah. And the way we're doing it is by proclaiming it and teaching it, as it says in the book of Isaiah, chapter 50, verse 4. He continues systematically to explain to us the real purpose behind Sefer Hageulah. Today we are in book 1, Sha'ar 1, chapter 1, verse 2, and we read together. Ve'ine chafetznu lechapes ha'inyan. Let me explain this part. He says, behold, I want to bring before you, before the inyan. The word inyan is the word evidence. He is like a lawyer. He's setting the evidence for the issue of the geula. Okay? And also they use the word evidence, ra'aya, singular. Not ra'ayot. Ra'ayot is plural. Ra'aya. He say, I have only one evidence. Okay? And he say, chafetznu lechapes inyan. I want to seek the matter or bring to you an evidence. Okay? And he say, tchila misefer Torat Adonai Atmima. And what is the what is the evidence? He said, I have only one evidence. The evidence is the Torah itself. In a second, we'll notice the language is used, the word Tmima. We'll look at that in a minute. He said, the evidence that we must look at when we're thinking about Geulah is Torah. Some people said the Torah is not a prophecy book. Well, Ramban would completely disagree. He says the Torah is the only tool that we have when we seek to talk about the Geulah, the future Geulah. And then he says, Asher darkeha darkei Noam v'kol netivuteha shalom. He actually quote from the book of Proverbs, chapter 3, verse 17-18. He said, because the Torah, the reason I choose the Torah, he said, because her ways are ways of pleasantness, and in honor all of her paths are paths of shalom. You know, those are verses are found in the Etzchaim prayer that we recite when we close this Torah service every week in the synagogue, okay? And then he shift gear, okay? And he says, Hidbarach, he praised God. Here we go. You know, he was praising God before it's restarted, and now he changed gear and he starts to praise God again. And I love it about the Ramban. In every step, he is praising God, and it's something we all can learn with. Hidbarach anotna. May the one who has given us the Torah bless. Blessed, he says, itbarach anotna, v'itadar al kise malchuto. May he be exalted on the chair of his kingdom. Okay? He is a king, okay? He says, he's a splendor king, and he says, may he be exalted. So we're kind of changing. And then he says, v'ismach amavia b'matanat chelko, and he says, and Moses, he's talking about the one who mavi, the word mavi in Hebrew, the one who brought, who is the one who brought the Torah, is Moses. And he says, may we will be rejoice at the gift that the Torah is giving us. And he's using here the word matana. Matana is a gift. He does not view the Torah as a law, a book of curses, or anything. He called the Torah a gift. This is something very, very unique about him, okay? And something that we can learn of. The Torah is a gift for Israel, okay? And here he continues. He says, Ve'yagila ama mekabelotam. Blessed be, not blessed, joyful be those who receive it, okay? Receive the Torah. Beheyot zcharo ito bepeulato lefanav, okay? Which means, those who partake in the Torah will receive the word sachar in Hebrew, the reward okay, the rewards that are found in the Torah. So he is focusing on the blessings of the Torah. So here is he saying, listen, I want to present to you the message of the Geulah. And he starts with the word Inyan, right? The word Inyan is a word that comes to explain to us how do we get from Galut to the Geulah. The matter here of the entire book, Sefer Hageulah, is how do we go from exile into redemption? So he says, I am going to reveal to you how we're going from exile to redemption. Just as you know, for example, we left Egypt from exile to redemption, right? And he says, the Torah is going to be our frame guard, okay? And then he says, I'm going to tell you it's going to be through Torah Adonai HaTamima. What is the word tamim, tamima? The first time we see the word tamim mentioned in the scriptures, it's used to describe Noah. It says that Noah was a tzaddik tamim. The word tamim means blameless. He, in essence, saying something very interesting. Rav Shaul says the same thing. He said the Torah is perfect, it's holy and pure. And that's what he's saying. He said the issue is not with the Torah. The reason we are in a galut today is not of the Torah. He is almost like a defender of the Torah. Okay? Rambam said the reason we galut is not the Torah. On the contrary, the Torah is perfect. And he says surely the issue of Geulah find in the Torah. Okay? Because the way are ways of peace, okay? He is defending the Torah, okay? And he's saying, although in the Torah there are things that are calamities, the things that are bad, he says ultimately the Torah is a way of pleasant and all of a way lead you to shalom. Why? He says the point of Torah is bring us to shalom with Hashem. Everybody need to understand that the Torah should bring us to shalom with Adonai, not to separate from Adonai. People think that the Torah is given so we will be separate from Adonai. God forbid. Kol nativotei shalom. Torah is given for us so we can marry God and to be in a perfect reunity with God, okay? And then he says, may his name be blessed, Yitbarach, Yitgadal, Yitkadash, Yithadar. He using some of the words from the Kaddish prayer to exalt him, okay? Why is he giving it? Because it says, because the Torah is worthy to be praised. The God who gave us the Torah is worthy to be praised, okay? And Moshe is worthy to be praise for bringing us. And if we will observe the Torah, he says, we will receive a geula. Okay, that is his point here. He said, Yagila ama mekabelota. Rejoice the people who receive the Torah truly. And the word here is mekabel, not do. There is a difference between doing the Torah, observing, but he used the word mekabel. That's where we get the term Kabbalah from. One who receive the Torah. Okay? Why? Because one who received the Torah will be transformed to the image of God. That is his point in this next verse. He's saying, we're going to resolve the issue of the Galut through the Geulah. But I want you to know that your greatest vehicle to bring you, Israel, to redemption is through the Torah. Torah is telling a story of the Geulah. And I think a lot of Christians understand that there is a redemption story in the Torah. But he's saying something else. The Torah is the vehicle. The Torah is the tool to bring us out of Galut into Geulah. That's the difference. Torah is a tool. Torah is not the final goal. The final goal is redemption. So in the next lesson, we will see that he furtherly, I broke the verse 2 into 2 lesson, he defined for us what this Torah is all about. But if we truly receive the Torah, it brings us to Geulah. And it's going to give us to the blessings, not to the curses, to the promises of the land. And that's what we are looking forward to. I hope you enjoy Sefer Hageulah lesson. Again, if you enjoy those, please consider partnering with us. God bless you. Until next time.